The Llama 3.2 vision model is now available for download and can be run entirely offline using Ollama. This means you can now chat with images directly in your terminal, using the Ollama SDKs, and, of course, using the Open Web UI. In this video, we will cover everything you need to know about getting started with Llama 3.2 vision, from the basic setup to using Open Web UI, and we'll also look at the Python and JavaScript SDKs. So check out the timestamps in the description of this video to jump to the section that might interest you. To get started, go to ollama.com and download the latest version of Ollama. You need at least Ollama version 0.4 in order to run vision models. We can then download the model by going to Models and search for Llama 3.2 Vision. The vision model comes in two different sizes, each providing drastically different quality and responses, but they also have drastically different hardware requirements. In this video, we will be using the 11 billion parameter model, but if you have the hardware to do so, then you can run the 90 billion parameter model. This model is about 8 gigabytes to download, and I will be running this on an RTX 4070 mobile GPU, but you should be able to run this on older hardware as well. In order to install and run this model, all we have to do is copy this command, then open up the terminal or command prompt on your machine and enter Ollama run Llama 3.2 vision. If this is your first time executing this command, then Ollama will automatically start to download the model, and afterwards you will be able to send it messages. And in order to test this, I added this image to a folder on my machine, and this is a thumbnail containing all sorts of texts and logos and this character. So we can chat with the model in the terminal by asking any question like describe this image, and we can then add the path to the image on our machine, which I called a.png. This will add the image to the chat, and within a few seconds, we start receiving the response from the model. I don't know about you, but I think this is incredible, especially for a model running on consumer hardware. This is correctly identifying the text in the image, like multi-stage RAG agents, so it's correctly identifying the title, the background description is correct, and it even identified the logos. Except for this Nubit AI logo, I'm not sure what that is, but the description of the logo is indeed correct. We can now terminate this chat by simply entering /bye. Now, of course, you might not want to use the terminal to chat to the model, and instead you can use something called Open Web UI that gives you a ChatGPT-like interface for interacting with your Ollama models. And I will show you how to set this up in a minute, but just to give you a quick demo, you can click on this drop-down to view all the available models that you've downloaded to Ollama. So let's select Llama 3.2 Vision, then we can click on Add, Upload Files, and select an image from our machine, like the one we used previously, and then we can ask any questions about this image, like describe the image, and as we saw in the terminal, we do receive the response from our model, but I just think this user interface is way more attractive to use. To set up Open Web UI is quite simple. First, go to docker.com and download and install Docker for your operating system. Then open up Docker Desktop just to ensure that the engine is up and running, and you should be presented with a dashboard similar to this. Now, obviously, you might not have any containers at this stage, and we will install Open Web UI together. In the description of this video, you will find a link to the Open Web UI GitHub repo. From this page, scroll down to the How to Install section, and more specifically, the Quick Start with Docker section. Then all you have to do is copy this first command, and then back in your terminal or command prompt, simply paste in that command. And what I like to do is to actually change the port that's being used from 3000 to something else, like 5000. And that is because port 3000 is being used by a lot of other applications as well, and this will avoid any conflicts. We can then press enter, and if this is your first time running this command, the Open Web UI image will be downloaded and a container will be created. So after that, if you go back to Docker Desktop, you should now see Open Web UI running on port 5000. By clicking on this link, you will be prompted to sign in or sign up for an account. Let's click on sign up, and don't worry, this is all running local, and this is not making any internet connections. These credentials are stored locally on your machine. Let's click on sign up, I'll enter a name, I'll enter my email as well as a password, and that should be it. And you should now be able to chat to any of the models that you downloaded via Ollama. All you have to do is click on this dropdown and select your model. You can also build your own applications using the Llama 3.2 vision model with Ollama. When we scroll down with this page, we can see examples on how to use the SDK, like the Python SDK, JavaScript, or we can call the API endpoint directly. But let's see this in action. First, let's see how we can use the JavaScript SDK. Afterwards, we'll have a look at the Python SDK. I've opened up a new folder for this project, and in the terminal, let's initiate a new project by entering npm init-y. We should now have this package.json file. Let's open this file and let's add one additional property below main, and that is type module. We can then close that file and let's add a new file called app.js. Let's start by installing the Ollama SDK. So in the terminal, we can enter npm install Ollama. At the top of this file, let's import Ollama by entering import Ollama from Ollama. We can now send messages to Ollama by entering ollama.chat, and we can then pass an object to chat, like the model that we want to use. And of course, we will be using Llama 3.2 vision. And let's also send a messages property, which is an array of values. We'll simply pass in one object, which contains the role, which is the user message. Let's also pass the content. This is the question, like describe the image. Then lastly, let's also pass the actual image. And this is also an array of values, as we can pass multiple images. So let's also copy over the image and let's add it to this folder. So what we can do now in the array is to simply pass the name of that image. Now, of course, if you store this image in a subfolder like assets, then all you have to do is also add the name of that folder to this path. We're nearly done. This chat method returns a promise, so we need to await the result, and let's assign the result to a response variable. So all we have to do now is console log the response. Let's give this a spin in the terminal by entering node and app.js. And after a short wait, I got my response back. And within this message property, we can see the response from the Llama 3.2 vision model. And although we won't look at it in this video, you can indeed enable streaming as well. Let me know in the comments if you would like me to create a dedicated video on building a React or Next.js app that streams a response from Ollama. Now let's have a look at interacting with the Llama 3.2 vision model using the Python SDK. I've opened up a new folder in the IDE, and because it's good practice, I will create a virtual environment by entering Python. If you are using Linux or Mac, this will be Python 3-m, then vnv and venv again. We can activate the environment by running venv scripts and activate. Then let's install the Ollama SDK library by running pip install Ollama. Great. Now let's create a new file and let's call this app.py. Then let's import Ollama. Now we can pass messages to Ollama by calling ollama.chat, and chat takes in a few parameters. First, we need to pass the model name, which is Llama 3.2-vision. Then let's also pass messages. And in this list, we can pass messages as dictionaries. So let's create a new dictionary. And within this dictionary, we need to pass a few keys. First is the role with a value of user, as this will represent a user message. The second key that we need to pass is the content, which represents the question from the user, like describe this image. And the last key we need to send is images, which is a list of images. So I'm simply going to grab my demo image and add it to the project. So in this list, I can now simply pass in the name of that image as a string, which I called a.png. And of course, if you created a subfolder, just remember to append the name of that folder to this text. Now what we can do now is create a new variable called response, which stores the result from this chat. And finally, let's print out the result by entering print and response. Let's save this And in the terminal, we can run this file by calling py followed by app.py. And as expected, we get the response back from our assistant. And in this content field, we can see the full response. Now, we won't cover it in this video, but you can also stream the response back. So let me know if you would like to see a dedicated video where we create a streamlit app using the Ollama SDK, where we stream back the response to the front end. If any of these sections helped you in any way, then please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Also check out this other video where we build a RAG chatbot using Llama 3.2, Ollama, and Flowwise. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.